The crowds are lining up outside the arena. They are ready for 01 Pro Wrestling USA, and we can't wait either. What a show we have for you, Jim.
Thank you, Mike, and a lot of those people are still talking about what happened last week in the tag team match. Harker Dirge finally able to get a measure of revenge against Bear St. Pierre, knocking the champion out in the middle of the ring and pinning him for a victory for his team. While Dexter and Doomsday tried to help Bear to his feet, Mike Galloway went in for a special report.
I caught up with Bear right after, and boy, was he in severe denial.
We're the champion!
I told you guys that if we stick together, nobody could take this title away from us. This is our title. Doesn't matter where they come from. You know, we're not letting any 01 USA combatants. None of our fighters are getting a shot at this title. Only outside talent from around the world. And once again, we've proven that the team of Bear, Doomsday, and Schwartz superseded.
What's it gonna take, Bear? What is it gonna take, Bear St. Pierre, champ? I just knocked you out in the middle of the ring, left you laying. And the one thing that you've heard me say time after time, if you're any kind of a man or any kind of a competitor, you'll put that championship back on the line against me. You see, you have something I want, and I thought knocking you out cold would get your attention. But I guess you're not that much of a man or a competitor, are you? Because you're continuing to face men in the ring who aren't even contenders. They're not even on the roster, while ignoring Harker Dirge. Bear, you might be embarrassed that you're the Illinois state champion. You might have loftier, grander goals of being the national champion with 01 Supreme Pro Wrestling USA. But understand this, the state of Illinois is where I was raised, it's where I was born, and the Illinois State Championship is one of those few professional wrestling prizes on the circuit that advertises exactly what it is. It represents the state of Illinois. It's not trying to be something it's not. It's not trying to be a world title. It represents all of the history and the tradition that is going on in this state where professional wrestling is concerned. So Bear, watch as I knock the competitors down one by one. All of them will fall, and you will have nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. I'm going to have you right where I want you, in that big old bear trap called the wrestling ring. Whew.
Strong words from Harker Dirge. He is looking to get his hands on Bear St. Pierre one more time. Mike Galloway, 01 Supreme Pro Wrestling USA. I'm Jim March, and in the ring right now, we've got the Assassin taking on one of your favorites, Mike.
Oh, the Mississippi Madman. I am a big fan of this guy.
Look out.
Oh, hey.
Whoa.
I guess we're going to start a little early.
The Assassin right away going after the Mississippi Madman. We saw these two compete two-on-two in tag team match just 2 weeks ago, Mike. But Adib has a grudge against the Madman, and he's got something to prove, but that's a Madman right there, isn't it?
Oh, I'll tell you, I said it before, I'll say it again, I would not want to be in a dark alley next to this guy.
Absolutely not. Adib trying his luck. You know one thing about the Assassin, Hassan Hadid? He thinks he's just as big and just as strong as the Mississippi Madman. I mean, he really has a big head about him, a huge ego, but he is a tremendous athlete, and he might be able to pull something off here this week, Mike.
So far, not so good. Mm-mm. Everything he's done to go to the Madman, all his offense has turned right into slop. I mean, he's bouncing off him, he's nothing.
Well, he thought about going another time, but thought twice about it, put on the brakes. Here he goes again, but Madman sidesteps him. Adib down and out for referee inside the ring right now, the head referee for 01 USA, Robert King. Mississippi Madman's not going to wait for the count though, Mike.
Can't grab any hair on that guy.
No, you can't, but you can grab the chin and grab. Madman grab just about anything he wants, can he?
Yes, he can.
Up and over? No.
You try to play on this. Oh, sorry. No, don't. Really? Madman just looking at him going, no.
Absolutely not. Looks like he was going for maybe a German suplex, but Madman too bit wrong.
That's just wrong, Jim. That's just wrong.
Absolutely, Mike. Good call right there. That's the uncallable maneuver is what I'm going to call that. A little bit of a rump bump in the end. Adib begging for mercy.
More timeout?
Mississippi Madman says, I don't think so.
Not going to happen. Not
I mean, it was Hadid who started this thing out, jumping at Madman over the top rope, and he angered the big guy. And that's something, like you said, you wouldn't want to meet the Madman. Very few would. But you got to give Hassan Hadid credit, the assassin. He went right after him, but right now he's going headfirst into that turnbuckle multiple times.
Track. Is it 10 yet? No, there.
Well, the people are keeping count.
Oh, no, there's that dance again. What'd you call it?
Is that a shuck and jive? Would you call that?
Not sure what that is. I don't know how to call that.
All right, let's call it like this. Mississippi Madman's got the moves. He'll give you the groove. Going in the ring against Hassan Hadid.
Oh, right into the camera. Here he comes. Oh, move. Hassan move.
Well, if he doesn't move, he's going to be a sorry citizen. Actually, because he's going to be squashed.
Star camera guy to move.
Oh, he took your advice, Mike. I think he heard you. He got out of the way. Got out of the way just in time. And now Madman hit that buckle hard. Hadid, a high flyer going to the top rope.
Oh, the big man goes down.
He got him down to one knee that time. And look at that victory celebration. Hadid, the assassin, celebrate. Ooh.
Man, he's trying to gather up some air.
Well, he's got a... Shake the cobwebs off, because he's been taking a pounding right now, and he's going after the arm of the Mississippi Madman. Mississippi Madman has that big Mississippi choke slam that he likes to use, and if Hassan Hadid can take away the arms, Madman won't be able to get him up in that pet hold. The assassin sees his target, goes after it. Back on top of the arm. Leg drop, looks like he's going for a short arm scissors here. Two count.
Like we said earlier, right before the show, we showed you a shot outside of all the great 01 fans, man. They are here in full force, and they are eating this show up tonight, Jim.
They're packed in. They're loving it. I'm loving it right now. We got a big matchup, and a big matchup coming up still, Mike. The Tag Team Championship is going to be on the line later on in the show.
That's going to be an interesting match.
A big match, and we'll tell you about that a little bit later. But look at Hassan Hadid, the assassin, showing his physique. He's proud of himself right now, and he should be. He has the Mississippi Madman, one of the top contenders here in 0-1. Has him down and has him hurting.
Madman is not feeling good right there. Ooh, another one on the arm.
One thing about the Madman, he's hard to take off his feet, but once you get him down, he does have a hard time getting back up. If you can just pursue the offensive on him, you're going to have a better chance. But Hadid is focusing on that arm right now, and I don't think he's ever going to get a submission on the Mississippi Madman. He's going to have to go for something stronger. Try to get a pinfall.
Oh, man. That pulls arm right out of the socket on that one.
He did indeed. He's proud of himself, though, but is he giving the Madman a little bit too much time to recuperate? He's hanging on to that rope. He's trying to resist, but right now he is having his... Oh. Nice reversal, though. He just used his weight for that one. It wasn't so much a technique move right there. Madman is still feeling it. Charges. Ran into nothing but a boot that time. Hadid going underneath. Oh, he got caught.
That wasn't a good idea there.
Uh-uh. Here we are again in the wishbone maneuver.
Oh, man.
And look at that boot that Madman dropped into the midsection of the assassin. One more time for good measure. Asking the people, shall I do it again? They think they'd like to see a three-peat, but Hadid caught on and caught that leg. Drops the big guy. Oh, look at that. He's favoring that elbow, Mike. It looks like he dropped right down on top of that same arm that Hadid has been working over. Unfortunate set of circumstances for the Madman. Could have dislocated that elbow, as a matter of fact.
What's he doing now?
Hadid's setting him up for something. Now he's going to try those power moves I talked about.
Second rope. Oh, man. One, two.
Ooh.
Not enough. You got to do a lot more than that to get the Madman, no pun intended, down.
Well, the assassin has a lot of moves, and we're about to see one right now. Elbow over the top rope this time. Use the ring rope as a slingshot there. Still only able to get a two.
He's working on the other arm now, Jim. He's really trying to get, I think, wear them both down, like you said, so Madman can't do his choke. He's really wearing both arms down, so Madman is totally, out.
Totally down and out. Is Hadid going to try to lift
him down?
Went for the fireman carry, had him up. Now he says he's going to body slam him. Got the big man up, but down all the way to the Madman on top of the assassin. Pulled up three count.
Three count. Hadid was going to get up.
Mississippi Madman hung in there, Mike, but I think the assassin beat himself on this occasion.
Yeah, he definitely did. He tried to pick him up, and that wasn't going to happen. And Madman landed on him and used his advantage and got the 1-2-3.
Your winner, Mississippi Madman. Wow. But still to come, the Tag Team Championship on the line. The champions, my guys, the Hooligans versus
my
Richards
guys
and O'Reilly. They can be yours, Mike, but they'll be ours next. And next week, a big match, the women's division, Thunder Kitty versus...
We're not sure.
A mystery opponent in the women's division next week.
The average text takes your eyes off the road for nearly 5 seconds.
It has been a busy few weeks for Jonathan Grisham, who arrived in Japan following his 0-1 USA X Division title win. A press conference was held to announce his opportunity to add two more titles to his waist as he agreed to face off against the 0-1 Japan Double Crown Junior Champion Shigewara. After a tremendous back and forth encounter where both wrestlers used every tool in their arsenal, it was Jonathan Grisham who would win the match and add more gold to his resume. Let's not forget the other side of the story. The former X Division champion, Oliver Kane, who has been dejectedly silent since losing the championship. Here's how Kane reacted immediately following his championship loss.
I don't know. I mean, this is my chance, my opportunity, you know, to prove I'm one of the best in the world. I mean, I've been working 9 years for this, and I just came up short. I don't know what I'm going to do. It's, if you can't be... I don't feel like talking anymore.
Hi, everybody. This is Brett Michaels. I've battled type 1 diabetes all my life. I wake up every day and I fight real hard, not only to feel good, but also fight hard to find a cure for diabetes. So let's go life to stop diabetes.
Zero One Supreme Pro Wrestling USA. Next week, we will see the Bizarre Hunter Dirge taking on the Bizarre Shank Barzini.
Hunter Dirge, they say you are the scariest man in Zero One USA. They say you're the madman. Mr. Rock and Roll. Harker Dirge, I challenge. I demand you in a squared circle. And I will show everybody at home in that tune who the real madman is.
That's one match that I want the lights on. Harker and Shank.
Absolutely. Mike, that is going to be a weird encounter, but a great encounter. Right now, we've got a title match on our hands right now. Those guys, Devin Mason, Cutter the Hooligan.
They're taking on Davey Richards, Kyle O'Reilly, and Team...
Well, we're going to find out real quick.
Is Aaron going to tell us?
Aaron Clark, what are they up to this week?
He does it better than I do.
Hailing from 1983.
Do you remember 1983?
I'm not going to say.
great job for 01. We'd like to welcome him into the family. He's part of us now. And what a match this is going to be. Jim, I'm not sure even... I'm not sure how I want to call this.
We have a study in opposites going on right now. The hooligans. All business. No nonsense. The tag team champions taking on what should be their toughest challenge to date. Those men right there. But they're acting a bit different than I'm used to seeing them. Davey Richards, Kyle O'Reilly, referring to themselves as Team Ambition from 1983. Clearly, they're going with a classic rock type of appeal today. I don't know what they were listening to in the car ride over here, but it certainly seems to have gotten them amped up.
Hank Jr.?
I don't think so, Mike. I think it might have been Air Supply.
Hey, you got letters from that last time.
Oh, well, I'll stop now.
That's okay. They thought it was just as funny.
All right, we've got Mason starting out on the hooligan side. Davey Richards is going to take it out on the Team Ambition side. But referee in the ring, Pops, might want to hang on right now. It looks like Davey Richards still has a studded heavy metal belt around his waist.
He does. It's still on.
And if you ask me, Mike, that's an illegal weapon.
Yes, it is. And there he goes.
Maybe he's going out to take that belt off.
There goes Kyle.
Yeah, there goes his buddy out there. Mike, get over there and see what's going on, because I think those guys should be in the ring. The hooligans think they should be in the ring. They're going to... they brought something with them. Get back over here and tell me what's going on back there, man.
They were trying to grab anything and everything they could from backstage to bring out.
And they got, what is this, a little workout bag, a punching bag or something? He's trying to hit the hooligan with it, but he hit himself in the head with it. And I don't know. Richards and O'Reilly right now seem like they're possibly fooling around with the hooligans. Maybe they're taking them lightly. This could be some sort of psychological ploy on their behalf, too. They're crafty, clever professional wrestlers. Richards is in good shape. He's taking a few laps around the ring. I don't think he's going to wear himself out doing that. But believe me, I think what he's doing right now, he's making Mason in that ring right now wait. He's making him wait to get another one of those forearm shots in. He can make him wait and get him nervous and make him want it. Mason just might make a mistake. Richards could be setting him up for that. Well, maybe I'm giving him too much credit, Mike. Maybe he's just insane. Oh.
Did he just kiss the boots of...
Well, he's telling him he doesn't want to wrestle. He'll kiss his feet instead. And he sure enough did kiss his feet.
Does he actually know or...
Oh.
That wasn't good enough. Do you know where those boots have been?
I have no idea if he knows where those boots have been. Hey, Mike, I think those boots have even been in Charleston. Oh. Who? But that's another story for another time. The story right now, the Tag Team Championship. Davey Richards shooting Mason across. Mason ducks once, ducks twice. Up and over, round and round he goes. Tilt the World Head Scissors by Mason Cutter. Davey Richards, look out, man. Drops. Got a drop toe on him, going over the top.
Oh, ouch.
Hurricane roll up for a two.
So that belt on, Jim.
He does. Pops needed to take that off at the bell, but right now it's a... Davey Richards trapped between two hooligans, and that's a place nobody wants to be. Richards out of the way, though. Going after one, going after the other. As bizarre, as insane as he's acting, give him credit. He's one of the top wrestlers in the world today. O'Reilly in now. Mason able to cut him off. Ducks under. And Team Ambition collide.
Ouch.
A little bit of a DDT action on his own partner, as a matter of fact. They had a good series of moves going. They were going for some sort of a double team, but it backfired on them. And now they're on the outside again, trying to regroup.
Richards went over right at the merch table.
Well, he's not having a good time right now with the hooligans, but he can certainly take out an 8x10 photo. Davey, you'll be charged for that later. We'll send you the bill. Right now, we've got O'Reilly down, looking to the comfort of the... Looked to me like he was taking a nap on that punching bag. And right now it's the hooligans using Richards and O'Reilly as a punching bag. But
now what does he have?
Well, he's found another weapon. Looks like he went under the ring.
Drill?
Yep. Looks like he found the toolbox under the ring that they used to set the ring up. He's got a power drill.
Okay.
Well, as Davey Richards shakes cobwebs out of his head and does whatever he's doing on the outside, Kyle O'Reilly's going to come in. No, now he's back on the outside, checking on his partner. We've got Devin in the ring. He can't wait to tie up with one of these guys. The Hooligans really got something to prove because a lot of people don't think they're going to be able to win this match. This is their toughest match to date, and they're against two of the best wrestlers in the world.
What is Kyle O'Reilly doing?
I haven't figured it out yet. I don't know if they're taking the Hooligans too lightly or if they've just taken too many shots to the head, and this is what they do now for fun, but the tag team championships are on the line. They've got to get wrestling now soon, I think. I mean, those stage antics. Paul Stanley does it a lot better, Mike, but it looks like maybe he's imitating Paul Stanley.
I bring the drill out again. Pops, catch the drill.
0-1, Supreme Pro Wrestling USA. Ladies and gentlemen, Jim March along with Iron Mike Galloway, and please bear with us if we seem just a bit confused because this is a confusing situation in the ring right now and an uncomfortable situation for O'Reilly, who took a shot down low as he was trying to get the drop on Devin Cutter of the Hooligans, the 0-1 Supreme Pro Wrestling Tag Team Champions. He's looking for a knuckle lock up now, challenging him.
Here we go, they're going to do a little Van Halen pound cake with the drill.
Classic rock, brought to you only by 0-1. Kyle O'Reilly now getting his rhythm going, but you know, we're not here to play classic rock. We're here to wrestle, and eventually he's going to have to get moving with it and figure something out. Kick to the midsection. Well, it's a start.
Oh, now we actually got some wrestling going. Cutter. Nah, that wasn't good enough.
Made a mistake. He wasn't going after the weak spot. He was going after the hard spot on Devin Cutter. Does it again to no effect. Devin's a hard-headed individual, literally and figuratively. I'm going to try it again. One turnbuckle won't do it. Third turnbuckle won't do it. I suggest they don't try to take him to the fourth turnbuckle. Boom. Go for a headbutt, though. I guess he figured his head was harder than the steel behind that buckle. It wasn't, and O'Reilly went down hard. Richards in the ring now goes all the way across, runs into Mason Cutter. Another hard-headed Cutter brother. And Devin inviting his partner into the ring right now. We've got all four men in the ring, and Pop seems to be just letting them do whatever they want to do.
Yeah, I think Pop's as confused as we are.
He might be intimidated. There's a lot to handle in that ring right now, and right now, the Hooligans are handling themselves quite well. The tag team champions have everything going their way. Richards down, O'Reilly down. Double up, Boston Crab. No. Slingshot.
Boom, double.
Both men hit those buckles, and those buckles did more damage to the challengers than they did to the champions.
Who's the legal man right now? I totally lost all sense of this match.
I don't blame you one bit. I've lost.
They both hit each other and drop.
Well, a somewhat unbelievable series of maneuvers here. The Hooligans having their way with the challengers. Davey Richards, Kyle O'Reilly. Mason on top of the cover right now. And a kick out by O'Reilly. Hooligans have them where they want them. Now, earlier they were running around, and now they've got them right in the middle of the ring for a forearm smash in a second.
O'Reilly definitely worked up the ranks. He's been around for a while, and he's definitely made a name for himself around the circuit.
He's been around the world, but right now he's in the ring with the Hooligans, and we talk about
that.
No, not at all. The Hooligans are wild. They're crazy. They are everything they look to be and more. And I said earlier, a lot of people are keeping their eye on this because they believe that Richards and O'Reilly are the Hooligans' toughest challenge to date, but I don't think Richards and O'Reilly have faced any tougher opponent than the Hooligans for a long, long time. And right now, Devin Cutter with a handful of O'Reilly's hair, and he is proving that they are the toughest. Well, the Hooligans.
Ooh.
With a double headbutt.
Ow!
That could be it.
One.
Oh.
Really? Come on, Pop, speed up there.
As if by instinct alone, able to raise that shoulder and avoid the three count. But these two are, the challengers are fighting for their very existence right now. They have been on Dream Street from the word go.
Ooh.
Again, a nice reversal. And
took him out, Richard.
Mason
out,
ran into
out.
He ran into a knee, but he didn't let that bother him, but that will bother any man on the face of this planet. And if it doesn't, sir, I got news for you. You got problems. Because that was a delicate area right now that got hit.
Kyle.
On top of the cover now. And a two count, but you can see that Mason is still hurting. In the low, low midsection, O'Reilly now shooting to the outside. Look out, Richards is out there. He's got something in his hand. He's got that belt. I had a feeling he was hanging on to that for a reason, and the reason is right now. In case they were in trouble, he wanted a weapon, and he's got a weapon. They were in trouble.
O'Reilly.
And he's distracting the ref with hip gyrations and anything he can think of. He's trying to bring the partner across. On top again. Strong two count. Now we've got Richards on the outside doing something again that I can't explain.
Oh, right.
Nice looking knee drop by O'Reilly. Again, a two count. He's going for it. They know they've got to put these hooligans away. They were fooling around earlier, but they got everything they could handle and more. And they know now that when they get the hooligans down, they better go for a cover and try to win these tag team championships.
Tags in after the boot to the head from Richards. Richards now in the legal man.
Snapmare has him down. We're going to see some wrestling now. Pins one leg down, pins the other.
Oh, ouch.
Steps over and he's got him in that good looking leg lock right now. It's doing a damage to about three different joints on Mason Cutter. Some hip wiggle action.
He must have been hanging out with the Madman.
Well, hey, that move right there, it does. It looks like the dance move the Madman was doing earlier, and it looks flamboyant. But at the same time, it is adding extra pressure to the legs of Mason Cutter. Davey Richards knows what he's doing. Even when he's playing around, he's doing something effective in that ring. It's all in the hips, Mike, here in 0-1 Supreme, Pro Wrestling USA. And Richards and O'Reilly now are getting a little bit serious. They want to take these tag team championships. And earlier we had an update about the X Division Championship. Our new champion, Jonathan Gresham, took that championship over to Japan. Not only defended it, but added to his list of accolades. And I imagine that Richards and O'Reilly would love to take these championship belts and add to their list of accolades. And right now they've got things going their way, and it is not out of reason that they just might do that tonight.
O'Reilly playing a little fiddle.
Well, once again in this match, Davey Richards, Kyle O'Reilly, they're feeling it. Feeling good about themselves and having a little fun now that they're on top of the hooligans. Oh, and double team air guitar. Never seen that before. Ooh, a double team kick.
Down boys go, yeah. Oh, they both got him. Spin right to the turnbuckle at the corner.
Getting the momentum out of the way.
Oh, move.
Look out now. Richards says he's going to get him. No. Drop.
Wait, the bread. Best kick.
We're going to call that the midsection they hit. They collided.
Good call.
Mason saw him come and gave him that nice drop toe and dropped Richards right into his partner O'Reilly. Devin looking for the tag now. He's got his room and he gets it. Devin in the ring now. Boom to one. Boom to the other. And he is taking both men out. All of his frustration sitting there watching his tag team partner, his brother, take a total beatdown are coming out now. And it is Devin Cutter with the inverted atomic drop.
Man!
Now we've seen a complete momentum shift. David Richards now. Going for a kick. He dropped.
Oh! He kicked his partner right
went
in the noggin.
Enziguri. And
oh, man.
It was Devin just one moment too quick for Davey Richards. Atomic drop now. Richards is out. The hooligans now in the double team position. And they've got things going their way. They like to double up, triple up, and quadruple up.
Oh, O'Reilly, and get out of boom. There, man. There's no hope for Kyle O'Reilly right now.
After that tumbleweed in the corner, he may be down. The hooligans both on top of the pin now. Richards able to make the save. So close, but yet so far now. Davey Richards knows he's fighting for the championship. He's got to take them both out. One on two if he has to, because his partner is really hurting. Richards hits the rope. No, he got caught. And he's in no man's land against the hooligans right now. Boom! And some of the patented double team maneuvers by the hooligans.
O'Reilly has the gall to make in the ring again. Wow.
Double stop. That could be it right there, Mike. One, two. Oh, so close. Right now, it looks like the hooligans have everything right where they want it. And I think they're going to successfully defend these tag team championships here. If they hit this one, they will for sure. This is their patented move.
Oh,
Richards able to make the save. Look out on the other side. One, two.
Oh!
Just inches away from having new tag team champions, Kyle O'Reilly, Davey Richards, and Devin Cutter right now realizes he has to fight for his existence, fight to defend those championships that he worked so hard to gain, but, oh, things are really picking up now. Those are some brutal kicks.
Oh,
got that left shoulder up. Richards making sure Mason can't come in and make a save. And right now they're going to get him 2-on-1 where they want him. They've got him. Devin Cutter right in the middle.
Rock and roll here.
They're tuning up. The challengers are looking to end this thing and take the championship away, but Mason able to slip out. Here he comes, Devin now. Whoa, wait a minute. We've got all four men in the ring. It's getting chaotic in a hurry.
Super kick
to Richards.
Super kick.
Look out on this side. It's a roll up. 2 and 3.
Gets
him. Got him. He did it.
Wow.
Incredible series of events leading up to the fall of Hooligans with a hard fought victory. Mike, they earned that one.
Holy cow. What a match.